Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Originally scheduled for yesterday, after a tad bit of a delay, the Starlink 4-10 mission lifted off earlier today.
One, engine full power, and liftoff, Falcon 9, Starlink 4-10.
The booster which launched the mission B-1052 landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. Unfortunately, there were no views of the booster landing this mission. There were some tweets posted by Jeff Faust. The first says a couple notes from a talk SpaceX President and COO Gwynne Shotwell gave at Caltech that just wrapped up. SpaceX had been working for a month and a half with the Ukrainian government to get landing rights in the country, and then they tweeted at Elon, so we turned it on. Next he posted, Shotwell says a 30,000 satellite constellation for Starlink is the sweet spot based on demand. Can't meet demand for the service now in the US. Emphasized commitment to space sustainability, since Starlink would be deep trouble if its orbit was junked up. Finally, he also posted saying Starship will change everything about space and that people haven't gotten their heads around it. Optimizing for mass or size will be dumb given the vehicle's performance and cost. No specific updates on Starship itself. There is a tweet posted by AST Space Mobile saying, this just in, we have signed a multi-launch agreement with SpaceX. The agreement covers the launch of the first Bluebird satellite and provides a framework for future launches. Heading over to Boca Chica, as always, work has been continuing on the orbital launch mount. The tower quick disconnect arm was seen moving a bit. The chopsticks were also seen being tested a bit. This staircase section was lifted into the wide bay as construction continues. Parts for a new crane have been spotted delivered to Boca Chica. The new booster transport stand we saw recently was captured being tested. Here's a view of a nose cone barrel section in the yard. There was a possible payload dispenser that was lowered into and installed inside this ring stack. Crews have continued to work on Starship 22 at the propellant production site. Here's a view of the Booster 7 lock section in the high bay. This upper ring stack for Super Heavy Booster 8 was spotted outside. This Booster 8 common dome stack has been spotted at the scrapyard. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures on the Cameron County website, the closures up to and including today were cancelled. However, there are closures scheduled for possible testing tomorrow, Thursday 10th, Friday 11th, as well as next week with Monday 14th. Finally, to finish up today's video, we have an updated Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis to take a look at. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there constantly filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming some of the Starbase content in this video too. As well, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.